Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In case you forgot, I am Jordan Meyerhofer, and this week I wanted to talk to you about Clara Schumann. Let's get right into it.
Clara Wieck was born September 13th, 1819 in Leipzig, Germany. Her father was Friedrich Wieck, and he was a major influence in her life, being both her piano teacher and manager for the early years of her career. In May of 1824, when she was just 5 years old, Clara's mother, Marianne Tromlitz, left her family and moved to Berlin with Adolf Bargiel, a friend of her husband's. This caused a lot of trauma for Clara as she was not able to see her mother and she was not legally her property anymore. In 1828, at the age of 9, Clara began her concert career. In the same year, she met Robert Schumann, who was then 18 years old. The two met while Clara was playing at the household of some friends. Robert was so impressed with her playing that he then became a student of her father's and moved into the family home to study. In 1831, at 12 years old, she began her first concert tour. Her tours took her through Austria, Germany, and Paris, which was then the center of the musical world at the time. Most of her piano compositions through Opus 11 were composed during this period, and she earned a sizable income through her concerts.
Clara's father played a significant role in what and where she played and how often she practiced. Her success brought more students and publicity to her father's business and provided prestige and status to the family. It's argued whether Clara's father wanted what was best for her or if he cared more about her earning potential. She also began teaching at the age of 12 because her father believed that every virtuoso should know how to teach. And when she was 19, she began paying her way by giving lessons in every city in which she performed. In 1836, issues arose between Clara and her father over her courtship with Robert Schumann. Robert asked for permission to marry Clara in 1837 when she was 18 years old, but for 3 years her father put every obstacle in the way of them getting married. He didn't believe that Robert could support Clara with his income earned from the newspaper he published and from his composing, among other issues. They appealed to a court of law for permission, and on September 12, 1840, on Clara's 21st birthday, they were married.
Throughout her career, Clara gave at least 1,299 performances. There are that many programs in the Schumann house at Zwickau. Her father was interested in crowd-pleasing music to boost their touring career, but as she got older, she focused on more serious music, such as Chopin's Variations Opus 2. She would also tailor her recitals to suit the audiences of where she was performing. For example, she played showy pieces for smaller towns, but in places like Leipzig, her home and a major intellectual center, she presented her most innovative and ambitious programs. By 1840, her repertoire centered solidly on the works of Beethoven, Chopin, Mendelssohn, and Schumann. By the time she was a well-established concert pianist, she apparently felt far less hesitation about including new or little-performed pieces in her public programs. Beethoven's Sonata, Opus 101, had apparently never been performed publicly in Leipzig until Clara played it in 1843.
Robert's music was a major part of Clara's concert repertoire. She performed his pieces in public soon after they had been written, sometimes almost immediately. She also arranged Schumann concerts with her husband, either matinees or self-sponsored evening concerts with programs devoted to Robert's music. Almost all of her concerts included at least one of his works. During their marriage, which involved Clara being pregnant a whopping 8 times, she played fewer concerts, but after Robert's death, she returned to a demanding concert schedule and remained active for nearly 35 years. Even the year after Robert's commitment to a mental hospital, Clara set out on tour. Using her friends and contacts from all over Europe, such as Felix and Fanny Mendelssohn, Ferdinand David, Franz Liszt, Jenny Lind, Julius Stockhausen, Friedrich Chopin, and of course Brahms, she planned programs, she scheduled halls, arranged for pianos and tuning, prepared and organized the distribution of tickets, and even arranged advertising. She was also one of the first artists to perform unaided by other musicians and to consistently perform memorized.
Composing was done on special occasions. The year before her marriage, Clara wrote in her diary, "I once believed that I possessed creative talent, but I have given up this idea. A woman must not desire to compose. There has never yet been one able to do it. Should I expect to be the one? To believe that would be arrogant, something that my father once induced me to do." In her late 40s, around 1868 through 69, Clara's health began to decline and deafness began to onset. She played as long as she was physically able, and in 1879, at the age of 59, she took a permanent position as the principal piano teacher at the Hochkonservatory in Frankfurt. The job had many benefits, such as a flexible teaching schedule, about 1 to 1.5 hours a day, being able to teach from home, and 4 months of vacation and time off that allowed the continuation of her concert career. She also had 2 assistants, her daughters Marie and Eugenie. She retired from the conservatory when she was 73 and continued to teach in her home until her death in 1896. Because of her innovations, she changed the format and repertoire of the piano recital from displays of virtuosity to programs of serious works.
Robert and Clara's marriage lasted 14 years, and in that time they were pregnant 8 times and had 1 miscarriage. She was pregnant some part of each year that they were married. During the years of their marriage, Clara gave 137 concerts and assisted many more. By 19th century standards, Robert was considered an enlightened husband. Obviously, Clara needed to perform to support the family financially, but Robert also knew that Clara could never give up on her art. In an age when women did not appear in public when visibly pregnant, Clara also performed even in advanced stages of her pregnancies. With the help of family, friends, and servants, Clara continued to perform, practice, compose, and teach. Not only is Robert's success owed to Clara for introducing his pieces to the public, but she also prepared piano reductions of all of his orchestral scores, copied music for him, rehearsed singers for his works, and accompanied choruses for him. She kept their home and artistic life together when he had his manic and depressive episodes. So in addition to caring for her children and managing her, and kind of his career, she also had to take care of her sick husband. She rejected the idea that women must devote their whole life to domesticity and motherhood. She balanced her home and career long before doing so was considered a possibility.
On February 27, 1854, Robert had attempted suicide and survived. Clara was not allowed to see her husband for several days, and he was taken on March 4th to a private asylum. She discovered she was pregnant shortly before his confinement. Clara would not see him again for 2.5 years. She finally saw him several days before his death, but by this time, Robert was incoherent and delirious due to self-starvation. The personal tragedies in her life only increased after Robert's death. She lost 4 adult children and her father. Ludwig, her oldest son, was mentally ill and confined to an asylum in 1870. Clara supported him until his death 29 years later. Felix and Julie both died of tuberculosis, and finally, Ferdinand died in 1891 of medical complications from chronic back pain and a morphine addiction. Marie, Elise, and Eugenie, the surviving daughters, took over the house after that. In 1854, shortly after her husband's suicide attempt, 34-year-old Clara met the 20-year-old Johannes Brahms. Brahms lived with Clara during her husband's confinement and visited Robert regularly in the hospital. Since doctors refused to allow Clara to see her husband, Brahms was their messenger. He gradually fell in love with Clara over this time, and he managed the family's finance books and took care of the children when Clara was away on tours. After Robert's death, he helped Clara edit Robert's complete works. She introduced him to influential friends and musicians and introduced his music to the world, wrote to publishers on his behalf, and accompanied him on concert tours. Their 43-year friendship was not always peaceful. After arguing over the editing of Robert's works, Brahms wrote to Clara on September 13, 1892, "It is hard after 40 years of loyal service, or whatever you may wish to call my relationship to you, to be thought of as nothing more than a bad experience."
Clara's life was dedicated to music, art, and her family. She died on May 20th, 1896, and is buried next to her husband, per her request. She left a legacy of beautiful music and innovative ideas that changed the structure of piano recitals as we know it today. Thank you guys so much for tuning into this video. I hope you enjoyed it and it sparked some curiosity about this fascinating woman. And I hope to see you soon for another video. Bye!